serious stuff still going on down south here. Wind speed's about 125 miles per hour. Now, you notice we all go, yes, 125. That's still dangerous. That's still near catastrophic. That's still going to cause all kinds of damage. Power outages that were all expected to occur all across the state of Florida are occurring right now. Some of the power over here in Sarasota County and Venice been off since 10 a.m., since 10 o'clock this morning. Can you imagine what, I mean, it's almost 10 hours now they've been without power and heading into a night tonight with no power, floodwaters. This big green thing you see right here, that flashing polygon, that's a flood warning that's in effect until 10:15 tonight, and then a flood advisory until tomorrow morning because of all the copious amounts of rain they've been getting. One good thing that has happened is that this big feeder band didn't cycle in here. It's going way up north, which is good. We do not want that coming in. This feeder band's not nearly as intense. You see all these big lightning strikes. If you're looking out the windows, which you need to be careful doing over in Flagler and Volusia County, probably seeing the night sky lighting up off in the distance because of those lightning strikes offshore. This particular band is not packing that kind of wallop for the lightning, but is packing more and more and more rain. And in that regard, I'm afraid the hits just keep on coming. Here's the way it looks as far as distance away from us goes now. You do see lightning strikes around the eye wall here still ongoing. So it's still a nasty Category 3 hurricane. And it's hard to fathom that we'd be excited to see it become a Category 3. But we're so happy that it's dropped on down enough. And it's far enough away for now that the wind speeds are starting to get edging ever closer into Polk County. See this right here? That's your leading edge of all the rough stuff starting to come across the county line into southern Polk. It's about 70 miles to 75 miles away from Kissimmee right now, bound for this direction, 81 miles away from you there in Melbourne. Wind speeds are down to 115 now with the 8 p.m. advisory, which is all good. Still gusting, though, to a buck 80. The pressure's 960 millibars. We really, 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 really need that to rise. Here's the way it looked as the sun was going down. You see the center of the storm is here, wobbling a little bit to the north and coming on up. We're going to go ahead and lose the satellite image now that the sun has gone down, so we'll move on. I just wanted you to see it one last time. Here's that track, and it brings it right toward the metro in the next several hours. You just saw it edging now into Polk County. Overnight tonight, works its way into Orange County, so between about maybe 5 and 7 a.m., we could be talking about big-time problems through Osceola and southern Orange counties with power outages going one right after the other as the core of this storm begins to move in. By 11 p.m. tonight, this is the way it looks. You see the core of the storm there at 2 a.m. trying to make its way in. I believe since this model ran, it slowed down just a smidge. But you get a vibe for the timing that by 9 a.m., a lot of the punch is to the north of Orlando. And then by 5 p.m. tomorrow, still clinging to Flagler County, but going the right way and beginning to check out. Here's one more look at the hurricane. Here are the winds right now. We had sustained winds of 41 miles per hour last hour in Daytona Beach. They diminished to 38, 25 in Leesburg, 33 right now in Orlando. And the wind gusts are a little crazier than that. 51 mile per hour wind gust in the last hour in Sanford and a 48 mile per hour wind gust in Daytona Beach, 45 in Orlando. Standing by now with more is meteorologist Candace Campos. Hey, Candace.
Well, Tom, of course, we're talking about that timeline because as the sun is starting to go down, it's inching its way into parts of southwestern Polk County. The timing is really going to, we're going to get more detailed in that timing pretty soon. So let's talk about the strongest winds for areas across our far southwestern zones, Osceola County, Southern Lake, Southern Sumter County. You guys will start to kind of see the real kick of that storm up by about 11 o'clock tonight. Slowly but surely, as Ian continues his track back out toward the Atlantic, we really will start to kind of finish off some of the strongest winds across most of East Central Florida by about 9, 10 o'clock tomorrow morning. So throughout the majority of the overnight, we will be seeing the heaviest rain, the strongest wind, and the highest threat for that tornadic activity. So, of course, staying alert overnight, of course, is something that is necessary no matter where you are in East Central Florida. So let's look at the wind intensity, another way of looking at the timeline of this. As it continues to make its way into Polk County, you can see there will be that chance of seeing about 58, 60 mile per hour wind gusts. By the time we headed, 74 mile per hour wind gusts as we start approaching parts of southern Polk County. And you can see that real center of the hurricane force winds, of course, starting to kind of diminish a little bit as it continues to weaken from a 3 to a 1 here as it approaches central Polk County by 2 a.m. But look at the areas here highlighted in that darker yellow. That means sustained winds of about 58 miles per hour. So who does that include? Most of Orange County, Osceola County, southern Lake and Sumter by very, very early tomorrow morning at 2 a.m. as it continues its track. More of East Central Florida will be under the strongest winds. All of Brevard, Volusia County, Lake, Seminole County as a possible Category 1 hurricane still by Thursday at 7 a.m. So we're talking by about daybreak early tomorrow morning. And then the bulk of the strongest winds as it weakens into a tropical storm, albeit a strong tropical storm, into southern Volusia County by about 6 o'clock. Thursday night. So as we, of course, talk about it, the majority of East Central Florida will be dealing with the strongest of Ian throughout the overnight hours, which is why we, of course, will be here around the clock, making sure we keep you guys updated on air, online, News 6 Plus, ClickOrlando.com, Pinpoint Weather App, Hurricane App, YouTube. We've got you covered, right, Tom? So we will be here. Don't you worry.